Hello, I'm Peter Gregg, coming to you from Miami, Florida, in our Christmas room. And I'm Peter Gregg from abetterbouncecard.com. Today, I want to talk a little bit about the Big Light Bounce Card. This is our bestseller, and this is the one that I lead people to when they write to me and they go like, I don't know which one to use. Should I use the Ultimate Bounce Card? Should I use the Mini Light Bounce Card? Should I use the Super Big Light or the Big Light? This is the standard go-to bounce card. It's a diffuser. It bounces the light from the flash forward and directly up. Now, I went through some soul searching on this unit, and I see the comments on that it's made out of a polyfoam and anybody can make it and stuff like that. Well, that's true. Plus, I have an earlier video that does show how to make the original bounce card, but we've come a long way, baby, a long, long way. Now, this is what the A Better Bounce Card Big Light looks like. Comes to you in professional packaging. Let's take one out as if you were receiving it today as brand new. And it comes with directions. It says 30 seconds to great pro flash pictures. Now, how do you get great pro flash pictures in 30 seconds? That's a tall order, isn't it? Not that big of an order. Okay, it tells you to do the following. Why don't we put one on together? This is a Canon camera. So I'll show you how it goes on the Canon camera. You take your camera, you take your flash, and you point it up to the ceiling. Then that's bouncing. Now you swivel it so that this way it's pointing to the ceiling. If you turn the camera this way to take a picture, all you got to do is aim it back to the ceiling again. That's not hard to do. So you aim it to the ceiling, you take your Big Light bounce card, you wrap it around, you put on the built-in Velcro strap, eyeball it so it looks pretty level, look at it, okay, and look at it from the back. Now it looks a little tubular, right? A little narrow. So there's a really hard trick to making this work right. You want to know what it is? Okay, when you get your new Big Light diffuser, you take your hand and slap it down. Just slap it down. Now when you do that, it takes on a beautiful half moon formation, and you're getting light firing still straight up towards the ceiling because the lens is now here. That means that there's nothing to block the light from going up. That's one of the tricks. I've tried to improve this. I've taken and gone to an injection mold company and all that kind of stuff. And the strength of the Big Light bounce card is that it's light. I mean, you can bump it, you can do all kinds of things to it, and it's not going to break your hot shoe, and it's not going to hurt the other person. Plus, another thing, if I was taking a flash picture that way, okay, it's got a beautiful black professional surface on the back. There's no reason for the light to go back and then come forward. It's out of the picture by the time it goes back. So why are we blinding everybody in the room? Let's not do that. Let me take my glasses off. I can see you so much better now. All right, so you put it on, slap it down. It's simple as that. That's on the Canon camera. Let's do a Nikon camera. You take your flash, you point it up, you turn it sideways. Let's open up another brand new one. Take it out of the packaging. And this packaging is even designed so that you can store them back in here. Just flop it in your camera bag, and it's a no-brainer. Okay, turn the camera so it's, you know which way is facing forward. Wrap it around like that. Take the Velcro belt, slip it in the hole. Now I know why I had my glasses on. Eyeball it, make sure it's on decently. You don't have to over-tighten it. Okay, set it up pretty level. Okay, now again, it's pretty tubular, so what you want is you want to do that trick that I showed you, 30 seconds, you strap it on, slap it down, okay? I even go like that a little bit sometimes. So now I have a beautiful Big Light diffuser. Again, on the Nikon, this is a D700. On the Nikon, it's going to bounce and send fill light forward, and it's going to, in an unhampered way, it's going to send light up to the ceiling. So if there is a ceiling anywhere that is cooperative in any way, it is going to give you ambient light raining down. And how about the Olympus? We've got the Olympus E3 with a beautiful f2.0 zoom lens. I can't tell you how awesome this lens is. Alrighty, so let's open up another one. We mailed it. We went to a betterbouncecard.com. We placed our order and it came in the mail. So you open it up and what did you get? You got a big light bounce card diffuser. So we take the Olympus with the Olympus flash, aim it straight up, turn it sideways. Okay, then you take, wrap it around. People want all these plastic things and cardboard things and all kinds of stuff up on their flash because it makes them feel better. But after doing a lot of soul searching, this is one of the best things that's out there. Again, it's a little narrow. So what do we do? We do the claw. Remember in wrestling, they have all these different things, the claw. We're going to take our hand, we're going to slap it down and fold it over. And voila, let it come back up and it's got its beautiful rounded shape and it's ready to take a picture. Look at this lens. Look at the glass on that lens. Isn't it awesome? So you're ready to take a picture and you focus and you can zoom and there it does double light because light is unaltered going straight up. You see that? You see that? Can you see that? Okay. And it bounces in this big wide semicircle sending light. I'm a little, you know, a demonstrative. Everywhere! So it sends light all over the room and it sends light straight up and it takes the least amount of battery juice because where it's a good large surface. It's about the size of a light sphere. It's about 10 times the size of a Stofen cup. Okay, and again, look at the back. There's no reason to send light backwards. People think that they're sending light backwards and they're creating ambient light. You're not. Okay, think of the flash as runners, like track and field. The light's going to take off from here and run straight to the subject. Okay, and when it's got enough light, the flash and the camera shuts it down. All right, so what you want is you want some powerful runners that can make it to the subject and ambient light, and therefore we don't cover the top. The light goes with the full power of the flash, bam, straight up to the ceiling. It hits the ceiling, it diffuses, and it rains down. Beautiful ambient lighting. This is the Big Light bounce card. See how easy it comes off? I don't even take and open my Velcro straps anymore. Okay, you don't need to do the camera trick where you're hanging onto this because you can knock it off and then you gotta bend over, pick it up, put it back on, okay? And then the next person can come along and then don't forget, slap, okay? The next person comes along, hits it, taps it, all kinds of stuff. Okay, it's made out of polyfoam. And on the back, it's beautiful black. On the front, it's reflective white. So this is the Big Light bounce card. It makes nicer flash pictures for you because it softens the light, it gives you a bigger, softer light, and it doubles your light because it's sending light forward and it's sending light up and raining down. Okay, and that is what the super big bounce card flash diffuser is all about from a better bounce card. All right, catch you later. This is Peter Gregg saying live from Miami. At least I'm live right now. You'll be watching it on video. So what's the saying? Is it live or is it Memorex? This is video, okay? And I'm still using my new Canon T2i that does the high resolution and it's color balanced with the Colorite Pro. And there's no studio lighting being used. This is room lights. And that's how well this camera does. I am so happy with that Canon T2i. Let's see what Nikon comes up with in video. All right. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.